Hey guys, Nylon here, and welcome back to another episode of my Minecraft Let's Play. And in today's episode, we're going to start it off with a level 30 enchantment. And to be more specific, we're going to be doing it on a diamond sword. Because I do want to get fire aspect on a diamond sword. And right now, we've just got sharpness and knockback. We do have a fire aspect right here, but this one's not nearly in the shape that we need it to be. It's got 35 out of 1,561 durability, and then over here we've just got some other random swords, but I think we're going to not craft one. What I think we're going to do is actually combine this one and this one together to give us a fresh sword to enchant. So let's go ahead and do that real quickly. Merge those into one, and yeah, we're going to be enchanting this at level 30. Like I said, I just got back from the skeleton grinder and got those. We were at level 24 before from killing mobs from, I guess, a sequence of episodes, probably episode 40 through 50 we were doing that. But yeah, I thought it was necessary to do a level 30 enchant because we haven't done one in a really, really long time. So this should be pretty exciting. Let's see what we get here. Hoping for fire aspect or something like that. And we got sharpness 3, knockback 2. Not what I was hoping for, but we will definitely take it. I think we have another one just like that. We got two sharpness 3s right here, so we don't have one just like that, but now we've got ourselves a sharpness 3 knockback 2. What we could do is combine these together in another episode, but I think we'll save that for later because I'm not about to go get level 30 again. Getting those six levels I think that I had to get earlier did take a pretty long time, so we're going to save that for another episode. But I do have something pretty cool planned for today's episode. We're going to go ahead and build a bridge from one side of the ravine to the other, and this is the ravine I'm talking about right here. As you can see, this is what we've been using right now. I'm going to take this dirt block out and this dirt block. Oh god, there's an enderman here. What's he doing out in the daylight? Kill this guy. Oh, he's in the ravine. And where did he go? I don't think he's going to teleport because it's daytime. So we'll go ahead and leave that guy alone now. There's a chicken over here. But yeah, we need to get rid of these little pillars that we have going on. We need to build an actual bridge. And to do that, we're going to need to collect a ton of wood because right now we are out of it. So what I've done is I've planted some trees over at the tree farm over there, and waiting for those to grow. It looks like, is that, no, I think that's from before. So we're going to have to go back over here and get some bone meal, because I don't think the trees that I planted have grown yet. So we're going to grab some of these and head over to the tree farm. What I think I'm going to do is I'm going to do a little bit of time lapse while we cut down these trees, because I don't want to bore you guys chopping these trees all down. So it looks like one has grown where I've planted it. We need to get rid of these huge trees because they are really tough to chop down because you got to pillar up and get all the stuff up there. But yeah, I think we're going to do a time lapse here and I'll be back when we're ready to build the bridge. Okay guys, so I am back and there's just one more piece of wood that needs to finish burning up there. These leaves will decay, and I think that's all good for the tree farm right now. We've got about a stack and a half of wood here, which I think should be plenty for the build we're doing. And yeah, that's what we're going to do right now. We're going to head over to the ravine and kind of lay out the design that we want, and we'll go from there. I did get some more potatoes from the furnace earlier this episode. I just checked in that chest a little bit while ago, and there's a lot of stuff that's finished cooking up. So we're gonna go ahead and grab that and put it in its appropriate chest. So this will go here and here, and the stone will go in here. So now we gotta head over to the ravine and start building that. The other thing I wanna do is I wanna fix up the part of the ravine where the stone brick is showing from the enchantment room. I'll show you guys what I mean in a second. I don't know if I talked about this when I was showing you guys the ravine beforehand, but we'll go ahead and look at that. But as you can see, there's a little part of the enchantment room that's sticking out here. I want to kind of cover that up so you can't see it when you're walking by. I think that should be fairly easy to do. We're going to have to make a little bridge over here so we can block that off, and I think that should be good, just so we can get it at a viewing distance when we walk across here, because I do think it looks really ugly if you can see the actual stone bricks, and you can still see some. That's a little better. We're going to have to pillar down a little bit so we can get those bottom parts here. Let's see, can we reach that? It's going to be a tough reach. We're going to do this, kind of cover it up like that. That, and there's one more. We should be good. The only way we'll be able to see it now is if we go in the ravine, and I don't think we're going to be going in here anytime soon, so that should be good. Let's go ahead and break all this and this here, and we'll be good. So let's head back over here. We're going to need to take down some of the stuff that we built in the ravine earlier in this series, just because I don't want this looking really bad when we look down here. And right now, this does not look good at all, this staircase. Actually, we might as well keep it. You know? Actually, no. No, we're gonna mine it up here. Let's go ahead and take it up like this. I think this should be fairly easy. Oh god, we messed it up already. Whatever, we'll just leave that there. We're gonna have to take it up block by block like this. Already screwed up again. So this is the only way we can do it. Like that. There we go. Getting a rhythm here. And hopefully you guys enjoyed that time-lapse song that I had. The link to that song is going to be in the description. It's by the same guy who does my outro music. Well, he didn't actually do it for me, but I just used it for my video for the outro. But if you guys want to see this song, the link will be in the description for that. Link to his channel is always in my description. It just says outro music, and you can click that to get to all of his music. But I think I'll put the actual link to this song in the description of this video. We're going to go ahead and take some of this out. This is where the bridge is going to be going. I think we're going to have a 3-wide bridge. And we're going to have to start it like right here. And maybe overlay it right there. I'm going to leave this little wood thing here for now, just so we can get across. But let's see. That is only 2. We're going to need 3. So let's move it over here and here. I think that should be good. So next we need to figure out what we're doing here. Let's see. Do you want a bridge like this? I'm trying to think. I think a bridge like that would look fairly nice. If we just go here, here, and then up one more, and we'll go like that across. Oh god, we just fell in the ravine. What did I say? What did I say? I knew we were going to fall back in here. Now the staircase that we took down, we can't even get back up. But we can pillar up with stone so it does blend in right here. But let's definitely not do that again, because I don't want to be falling in this ravine anymore. Let's get back up here. That's exactly why we're building this bridge. Already proved my point. There we go. So what I'm thinking is maybe we'll just have it like this. It could work. Or I might leave it how I had it, like right here. We're gonna see how this looks. I think I have something similar to this built. Get out of here, sheep. Oh, he made his way across the bridge. I thought I was gonna hit him in. And the reason I'm putting this here is so we can stack the wood on top of it. Like this. I don't know if this bridge is gonna be too tall now, but I think it should be fine. If we do it like this, it's going to be a pretty natural bridge, I guess you could say. If you can call a bridge natural. Let's go ahead and do that. And then this, not gonna fall in anymore, that's for sure. And build that across, go back over here and finish that off. We do have another stack of wood, good. Thought we were gonna be a little bit short, but we're not. And then bring it all the way across like that. So the next thing that we need to do is actually remove this cobblestone, because we're not gonna be having that. We're also going to need to build the actual place where we stand on the bridge. I think I built a similar bridge to this on the Nyloncraft server when we built that spawn. And we're gonna go ahead and do this. Put a block right there. So it looks like it's actually supported. We're also gonna have to remove some of this right here. And put some half slabs. Then we're gonna use some stairs slash, oh, we can't do slash craft. We're in single player. I was about to do a mineage command slash craft, but obviously you can't do it in vanilla single player. And go ahead and craft us up some stairs and some half slabs. We might as well just do that right now. And should be good. Let's try this out here. Oh, that's an upside down stair. We don't want that. Like so. And then here. So it's going to be like that. And then at the top here, we're going to be placing half slabs. Like this. Now I could place them upside down, and I think that's what I'm going to do. That's exactly what I'm going to do. Like this. I wonder how that looks from the outside. I don't think it'll look bad at all. We're gonna go ahead and do that. What I could do is I've got an idea here. I've got a pretty good idea. And it is nighttime, so we're gonna have to go and sleep real quick. Pick up this chicken egg, chuck that over there. Did not hatch a baby chicken, it's too bad. Let's go over here and sleep through the night. Now I think what we need to do is we need to make a few beds to place around the base, because I always find myself running over here every episode, like every 10 minutes or so, because that's how long a day and night cycle, or just a day cycle is. And I don't really like running over here while I'm building, because I just had an idea fresh in my mind, and I think I might have lost it. No, never mind, I didn't lose it. I think we can still do what I was thinking. And that actually looks really nice from over here, just looking at it right now. Walking straight up here, and I almost just walked straight into the ravine. Let's go ahead and craft a few more half slabs here. There we go. Put that down. We're gonna go ahead and remove all of this now because we don't need it anymore. We now have an official way to get across the ravine here. Like that. So what I was thinking is we could remove this right here. Remove every other block along this bridge like that, and we're gonna put fences in between there, and then on the bottom we're gonna run this across like this. I think that will look really nice from the outside, and we're good. Do that on the other side and put some fences. We could also use half slabs. That's another choice we have. But I think it will look the best if we use actual fences. So we're going to go ahead and try that out first, and I'll see how we like it. Well, let's look from afar here. See how that looks. I think we need to put some sort of stair at the bottom corner there, if that makes any sense. And we're also going to need to put the fences that I was talking about. So let's go ahead and craft those up real quick right now. Craft us up some fences. And that's good. 10 should be just enough. 2, 3, 4. Didn't mean to place those there. Let's take that out and that out. Do that for the other side. Looking good. And then what I was saying is we're going to need to place some upside down stairs here. I think we can do that pretty easily from down here. There we go. And I think we'll do that on the other side over there too, so it makes it look a little bit better. Let's go over here and do the same. Hop down there. Pillar out here a little bit. And put that upside down stair on this side. I think that should finish off the bridge right there. I think that looks really, really nice. We're going to go ahead and look at it from afar now that we've got the fences and the upside down stairs on it. And see how that works out for us. So let's see here. Let's look at it from this direction. Yeah, I really do like the look of that right there. Could use some support on the other side. But I think it does look fine. It looks like it just goes straight into there. And the one last thing that we could do is place some torches on the side. So I think we're going to do that, and then we'll probably call it an episode here. But yeah, we've got a nice way to get across this ravine now, and it actually looks very, very good. Yeah, it looks great from over here. So I'm going to go ahead and grab some torches so we can place those on all the logs. And I think we have some coal in the coal chest. Actually, I know we have some coal in the coal chest. I think we've got like 9 or 10 stacks in there. Go ahead and check that out. We're gonna grab ourselves. Oh, we already have torches on us. What am I thinking, guys? I have torches in my 9th slot right here. We're gonna go ahead and use those. I think I just went blind for a second. Although torches are hard to see, like in your inventory, I guess. No, I'm just trying to make myself feel better that I couldn't see them. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and put those on here. And on this side too, so we can light this all up. So no mobs will spawn on the bridge. Now, I don't think that looks the best. I think we're gonna remove the middle ones right here. Leave the center one. I think that looks a little bit better. And I think that looks really good. Let me know what you guys think about this bridge in the comments. I'm pretty proud of it. But yeah, I think that's probably gonna be it for this episode. If you guys did enjoy, remember to hit that like button as it really does help out this series. Let's try to get this episode to 1,000 likes if we can. But yeah, again, I'd like to thank you guys for watching. And I will see you guys next time.